Hey guys, so my author that I chose was Laurie Halse Anderson, and I decided to read Speak. So this is the book, and it was published in 1999 by Square Fish, and some awards that it's gotten are the National Book Award finalist, a Michael L. Prince Honor Book, an Edgar Allan Poe Award finalist, and a Los Angeles Times Book Prize finalist. And the cover calls it the groundbreaking novel that changed everything. And at first I was like, wow, that's kind of like, you really think highly of yourself there. But after reading it, I really understand. And before I read it, I'd actually already seen the Lifetime movie that they made. And from what I remember, it stays pretty true to the plot. But the book is, it's about a girl named Melinda, and she is a freshman in high school. And the summer before her freshman year, she went to this like big high school kegger with her best friend and ended up being raped by a guy who was a rising senior at what was soon to be her high school. And so she called the police because she really didn't know what had happened. She didn't really understand. So she called the police, and of course the party got busted and everything. But she didn't actually tell the police that she had been raped. So everyone at school hated her because they knew her as the girl who had busted up that party. Or if they didn't know her for that, they didn't know her at all. She was completely invisible. And her best friends ended up turning on her because of what she did at the party. So she really had no one and just became a total pariah in the school. And it wasn't helped by the fact that she felt like she had lost her voice, figuratively and also kind of literally, because she barely talks to anyone. You know, she doesn't really have any friends to talk to, and she really doesn't even talk to her parents either. So the whole book is about just her trying to navigate high school, being alone and feeling like a nobody, and also dealing with the trauma of what she went through. And you see her come to realize that what happened to her was actually rape, because she was so young and she was drunk when it happened. She just really didn't understand. But she eventually comes to realize what happened and the implications of that. And you have to see her be in school and see the guy who raped her. And he actually starts dating her former best friend. So obviously she is not happy about that. So she tries to tell her, the friend's name is Rachel. She tries to tell her, but she doesn't believe her. Melinda's parents, you know, of course they don't know what happened, but they still just really don't understand. And so Melinda, the only place she really feels at home in school is in her art class. She really enjoys expressing herself and learning how to express herself, because she's never really done that before. And she also kind of like commandeers a janitor's closet and turns it into her own little like hideaway. So she starts to gain some more confidence and to, you know, really come to terms with what has happened to her as much as she can. And she eventually, you know, she tells her ex-friend, Rachel, and after a little while, I guess after kind of chewing on it, Rachel believes her and ends up breaking up with him. Well, Andy is his name. He's not very happy about it, so he confronts Melinda in her closet, and her closet, like the janitor's one at school, and ends up trying to attack her again, but she screams no, and some people come in and kind of, you know, break it up and go to get help and everything. And then the novel ends with her talking to her art teacher, and he says, you know, wow, you've really been through a lot, haven't you? Because now everyone in school knows what happened. And she says, yeah, let me tell you about it. Which is really cool, because the whole novel she hasn't been able to talk about it. So that's the basic plot, all the main points. I really, really enjoyed this book. Like I said, I had, you know, seen the movie before, but which I thought it did a pretty good job. But you know, there's something about reading you know, what it came from. And I just think it's so important because rape is something that people don't like to talk about. If you're talking about it seriously, people don't like to talk about it. But people do love to joke about it, which I really, really, really hate, and have spent a lot of college really educating myself, because I used to be one of those people who, if you heard about a girl getting raped, you would say, oh, well, what was she wearing? Was she drunk? Where was she? What time was it? All of these things as if we are justifying why it was that she was raped, which is obviously so wrong in so many ways. So I think this book is a great way to kind of open up that conversation. And I know when I saw the movie a few years ago, it really made me think, because those were things I hadn't really thought of before. And a quote that I really, really loved in the book, it's Melinda's art teacher talking, and he makes them, the students, he gives them one object that they have to draw or paint or sculpt or whatever, but that's the only object that they can make for the whole school year, and Melinda's is a tree. And she's kind of struggling, she's kind of stuck, even though she's a good artist. She just doesn't really know where she should go next. And he's trying to tell her that this, you know, it doesn't really matter as long as she's expressing herself. So he says, the next time you work on your trees, don't think about trees. Think about love or hate or joy or rage, whatever makes you feel something, makes your palms sweat or your toes curl. Focus on that feeling. When people don't express themselves, they die one piece at a time. You'd be shocked at how many adults are really dead inside, walking through their days with no idea who they are, just waiting for a heart attack or cancer or a Mack truck to come along and finish the job. It's the saddest thing I know. And that really, it really struck me and, like, kept me thinking about that quote for several hours later. I mean, days, really. And, because I totally agree. I think that's really sad, and that's hitting at the major issue of the novel, is that Melinda isn't expressing herself, and so she really is dying one piece at a time. And I think that's a really important message, that, you know, you need to be expressing yourself, and you need to be speaking, whether, you know, verbal or writing things down or making art or whatever. You have to express yourself, especially if you've gone through something traumatic like Melinda did. And I also love, I talked about how the book ends where she says, you know, her art teacher's talking to her and he says, you know, I can tell you've been through a lot. And she says, yeah, let me tell you about it, because it's just so, it's so powerful when you've seen the whole book, her not expressing herself. And whenever someone asks, you know, how are you? She's like, oh, I'm fine, or she doesn't say anything. So it's so powerful when she says, let me tell you about it. I think you could teach this book. I probably wouldn't teach it in middle school, just because of the subject matter, but it's really easy to read. I think I read it in like 3 pretty short sittings. But I feel like 9th grade would be the ideal grade to teach this in. Because Melinda is in 9th grade, and I think, you know, freshmen in high school kind of all have that camaraderie of, like, being a little fish in a big pond, and I think they could, be able to connect with her more. And, just also the fact that it's easy to read, it would be fine for them, difficulty-wise, and it's just so important to discuss these issues and to discuss rape and rape culture and what that means. And I know I wish in high school that someone had told me, you know, when someone is raped, we don't ask what was she wearing, we don't ask was she drunk at a party, we don't ask why was it the victim's fault, because that is never okay. And so I think that's something really important that students need to be discussing, that I didn't discuss it in high school, I don't know anyone who did, unless maybe they read this book, and especially for men, because, or young men, because we don't really teach our boys not to rape, we teach our girls not to get raped, so I think that would be really important for them to hear as well. As far as what kinds of things you would discuss when reading the novel, other than like themes, I would use this to talk about voice, like the speaker's voice in a novel, because Melinda's, you know, she spends the entire novel developing it, and it's an interesting place to be because she's not expressing herself to anyone else, she's just expressing herself to the reader. So I think that would be a good thing to talk about, and what effect her voice has on the novel as a whole. You know, how different would it be if this were, you know, like a third-person omniscient narrator, or if it were narrated by her friend or by her rapist? Like, how different would it be? And one activity that I think would be really cool to have students do is to write their own extended ending, because it ends... you know, with everyone finds out that he raped her, and, you know, you see that Melinda is starting to become stronger, and people in school are recognizing her as that girl who busted Andy Evans, and so she kind of gets, like, a little bit popular from that, which is cool, but, and then it ends with her talking to her art teacher, so you never get to hear if he was convicted or... he was a senior, so where does he go after that? What happens to Melinda the next year of school? She has her lab partner, and there's kind of maybe like the beginnings of a romance there, so you never really get to find out what happens there. And at the end of the book, there's a little authorial note where she's talking about how she's not sure if she's going to write a sequel for it or not, and how she kind of goes back and forth, but she really wants to wait until she gets like a clear vision of what that next step for Melinda should be. So I think it would be really cool for students after reading that note to write their own extended endings and to say, you know, how they thought things progressed after that or should progress after that. And, you know, did Melinda continue to get stronger? Did she, you know, lose her voice again? And I would just love to hear what they think would be the best way to end that. So that's it, and thanks for watching. Bye.